Launched in 1985 in coincidence with the Mark 75th anniversary, the Alpha 75's combination of sporting look, lusty engines and handling prowess made it a commercial success, at least in Italy, where its status as arguably the last classic Alfa Romeo has ensured the preservation of many examples to this day. But if there's one Alfa 75 to rule them all, it's certainly the Turbo Evoluzione IMSA race car. And here's its story. The story of this badass Alfa 75 is deeply intertwined with the race it had been specifically designed to win, the Giro Automobilistico d'Italia. Organized by the Turinese section of the Italian Automobile Club, it was inspired by the success of the Tour de France automobile, and it followed a similar formula that included tarmac rally stages as well as circuit races. Such diversity made the Giro d'Italia, first held in 1973, arguably one of the most complete four-wheeled competitions around, attracting top-class cars and drivers every year until 1980. Following a several years hiatus, the event was organized once again in 1988, and the Fiat Group, then going through a very successful phase from both a commercial and economic standpoint, was going to leave no stones unturned to ensure a victory. The challenge was taken up by Alfa Romeo's racing arm Alfa Corse, which, following Fiat's takeover of the Milanese mark, had been placed under the direction of the great Giorgio Pianta, who had won the 1975 edition of the Giro d'Italia driving the Abarth O31 prototype. With just over 2 months available to prepare, the engineers had no other choice but to start from what was already available, the Alfa 75 Turbo Evoluzione Group A Touring Car Racer. To broaden the entry pool though, the event's organizers opened the door to American IMSA Endurance cars on top of the regular FIA Group N and Group A racing cars, which allowed Alfa Corse to unlock quite a lot of extra performance from the 75. The Alfa 75 Turbo Evoluzione IMSA could therefore not only be made lighter, tipping the scales at just 960 kg, but also much more powerful. The 1.8-liter twin-cam engine produced around 335 horsepower for 1988 and 400 for 1989, thanks to a very generously sized turbocharger. According to Alfa's development driver Giorgio Francia, this was an increase of 50 to 60 horsepower on top of the 75 Group A that were racing in the Italian Touring Car Championship at the time. But, as Pirelli's once famous advert said, power is nothing without control, so the less restrictive American regulations came in handy once again. Tires and tracks were enlarged, with massive box fenders to cover it all up, while the Dedion rear suspension was also redesigned to allow for camber adjustment, something not usually possible with this suspension layout. If the Alfa 75 Evoluzione already wasn't a paragon of understatement, the IMSA definitely turned the aggressiveness up to 11. It looks bitchin', and watching it thunder down a rally stage must have been a sight to behold. Alfa Corse's effort paid off handsomely, with the 75 turbos demonstrating a crushing superiority in 1988 and 1989. In the first year, the winners were Riccardo Patrese with Mickey Biasion and his navigator Tiziano Siviero, while in 1989 the honors went instead to the team composed by Giorgio Francia, Dario Cerrato and Giuseppe Cerri. Unfortunately though, the 1989 edition of the Giro Automobilistico d'Italia would also be the last, much to the disappointment of enthusiasts and drivers alike. Although 2011 saw a new edition of the classic race, it largely failed to reignite the old enthusiasm, and at the time of recording, there are no plans to revive the event anytime soon.